Hey guys, welcome to Aaron's Automotive. Today I'm going to show you how to diagnose a bad alternator, a quick and easy way without any electrical tools and multimeters, battery testers, anything like that. If you watched a couple of videos ago, I replaced the alternator in my 82 GMC. And I was driving around town today. It's a little nice, water, you know, some water on the road from the snow melting. Splashed through a puddle. And I think I fried the alternator. So I'm going to show you why I think, and show you how to test that. So, voltmeter. It's reading about 12-ish volts. And I'm going to go start the truck. And most times, you would see the voltmeter, or the battery meter, or whatever, climb to 14 and a half. It doesn't. Turn the fans on and voltage will drop. Not much, but a little. So, I'm going to show you how to test that. You're going to need a wrench or a ratchet with a socket. And with the vehicle running, you're going to go over to your battery. And you're going to disconnect the battery terminal. If the truck dies, the alternator is bad. If the truck stays running, then I got a different issue. And just loosening it as you see the truck die. The alternator should put off enough power that if the battery is bad, the truck would still stay running so you can get from where you're going to your destination. In this case, it's dead. So, back to the end, or to the cab. We'll crank the key. And you can see there is no voltage, so the battery's disconnected. I'm gonna duplicate this test. Tighten the battery terminal. Power again. Fire up the truck, and we'll disconnect the battery again and see if it dies. All right. Well, I'm going to disconnect this because I'm going to be going back to the parts store. Exchanging the alternator for a new one. So, and because you want to always disconnect this when you're taking off battery or electrical components like alternators or anything like that. So, that's a quick guide on how to check your vehicle, the charging system, if you think your alternator is faulty. In this case, it is. Alright, so when got the exchange on the alternator that I replaced on the 1st of February, they were, it was quick, it was easy. Thankfully the parts store has actually only about 5-minute walk. I'd actually reconnected my battery, electrical taped this connector off, and drove there without an alternator. So, I still have a belt on my water pump and crank pulley, power steering pump, so no issue driving it to the parts store. It was like a 2-minute drive, if that. Made it there just fine. Made it back. So, I'm gonna swap in the new alternator and I'll show you guys when that's done. I'm not gonna film it this time. It's really windy out and I just wanna get it done. So, I just about had this alternator installed. I was going to tighten down the bolts. And this is why you shouldn't work on vehicles when you're having a horrible day and when you're upset. This makes your day go worse when shit breaks. Using a wrench, tightening down this one bolt, sheared the head right off. Just sheared it, gone completely. So now I gotta get this broken bolt out of here. not really what I wanted to do today, but I'm just glad it wasn't the bolt that goes into the block, or into the cylinder head, or valve, whatever. I can't even think right now, I'm just too upset. I'm just glad it wasn't the bolt that goes into there. So I guess I'll, I don't know. I'll try some vice grips on the back of that and try and spin the bolt out. If that doesn't work, I will try and drill it and use an easy out. Not really going that good today. Alright, well, new alternator's in. Got that bolt out. Didn't damage the threads too much. Grabbed a new bolt from my little supply bin and a washer. Got it all bolted up. Cleaned up the threads with a tap set. Like I said, I'm sorry I'm not filming most of this. I'm just too frustrated to really care to film it right now. The old bolt that broke. Grab it. Put this wrench down. That's the bolt. Sheared it right off. Buggered it up pretty good when I was trying to remove it. But, oh well, garbage. Garbage can's right there. So, we're gonna fire it up and see if the alternator is working or not. Fire it up, disconnect the battery cable, and I guess we'll also check the voltmeter here on the truck's gauges to see if it climbs. Good. So it's showing 14.5 volts now. I'm going to disconnect the negative battery terminal and see if it stays running. These are just for my internal battery charger inside the cab along with my power inverter, so they'll have no effect on the vehicle at all. Woo! Alright, it's still running. And to prove to you that the battery is disconnected, got my interior light on. See when I turn the fan on, how everything jumps a little, puts a big load on the alternator, but most important, check the lights. So that just goes to prove that the battery was disconnected. So this we'll reconnect it. Hard to do one-handed. There you go. And this will be getting switched out to a top post terminals very shortly anyways. There. So they're reconnected. You can see the lights are back on. Fire the truck. There we go. So, I guess that gives you a little idea how to check if your alternator is good or bad by starting the vehicle and disconnecting the battery. I'll show you what happens when the alternator is bad, what happens when the alternator was good, along with a very frustrated me with having to deal with that. I know it's something minor, it's something that I know I shouldn't get all upset about, but I did. Now, it's windy today, it's cold out, and the last thing I really wanted to do was deal with a warranty on my alternator. So, hope you guys found this video, if at least anything, amusing. Take care.